Dengar tak lagu? Masa lagu je. Filter cantik. Filter yang ada semua filter lawa. Tak apa. Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Oh, why my voice sounds so intimidating? Hey, sekali. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for being here tonight. For you are deserving. Ask me away. My voice keep getting very small. I don't know why. I've been preparing for this. Anyway, hello and thank you for being here tonight. So, I attended this live video as an Ask Me Away for my book, You Are Deserving. Okay, nak tunjuk dulu kan? Okay. Satu dah aja. So, this is the tajuk. This is the title, You Are Deserving. Firstly, the color is so pretty. Oh my god. Like, if you've been following for a long time, you know I like the color blue. So it has a really nice blue, young blue. Wait, young blue? Like, it's a literal translation of biru muda. Like, light blue, yes, that's what I meant. Light blue. And it's very golden. Like, you know, when I completed the book, I cakap jambu-jambu ya, like I cannot talk in full Malay or full English. So when I already finish the writing the book, I know dalam kepala I will receive the book. In my head I know that this book will be a part of the comfort series. So comfort series ada lah dia punya, like, you know, dia punya cover, it's quite uniform. So I can imagine lah sikit-sikit, oh, this is the kind of cover it will be. But the moment my editor hantar the cover and I was like, oh my god, it's so pretty. Like, the blue is so pretty and then the golden, what should we say, tulisan to golden. It's so pretty and when you shine it on the light, like, it's so pretty. The thing is, like, I balut ni dengan plastik tau. So, dia punya, if you shine it's a bit distracting lah, but kalau you tak balut dengan apa-apa, it's just macam kulit ni je, you shine it by the light, oh, lawa. Lawa, I really like it, you know. So, this book, let's check out the bahagian belakang. So, I'll read to you a bit of the blurb. The blurb. At any point in life, have you ever felt like you don't deserve anything? You know, I'm stuck at this project. I shouldn't be the one to lead it. I feel like I don't deserve love from anyone. And we might ask ourselves, you know, am I worthy? And am I good enough? So the feeling of unworthiness sprouts from one root cause, insecurities. As human beings, we share certain collective experiences and thoughts revolving around self-worth and the feeling of deservingness. Through this book, readers will be transported back to Prophet Musa alayhi salam time, before and during his prophethood. The story of Prophet Musa alayhi salam transcends time and cultural boundaries, speaking directly to the universal human experience, make it worth to ponder. Just like Prophet Musa alayhi salam, you too are deserving of anything that this world has to offer. So, I get this question a lot. You know, what inspires you to write this book, you know, specifically? So the thing is, the story of Nabi Musa has always been on the back of my mind. You know, I've always been very impressed by the story, and I use it whenever my friends tell me about their own insecurities. Actually, I put that story in chapter 1. So literally, chapter 1 starts with the story of my friend. Should I read it? Okay, I think I might read it. So, amidst the celebratory ambience of an old friend's wedding, I got the chance to meet another old friend of mine. Our brief exchange at the wedding only deepened our nostalgia. And so, the desire to catch up in a more tranquil setting led us to Tea Life, nestled in a nearby quiet mall. My friend is a bachelor's graduate in Arabic language and literature, and she had been entrusted with a significant translation project at her workplace at the time. I couldn't help but to look at her with respect. She is such a great person. However, her words revealed a profound sense of self-doubt that silently shattered me. So she said, "I don't think I'm qualified enough to do the translation. There are way better translators out there than me. Maybe I shouldn't do it." She felt undeserving. So it is during, that's literally half the story. So there's another half of the story if you want to look at it. So, and the thing is, this is one story that I put in the book. I've met countless of my friends, you know, when being asked, they have their own insecurities of, you know, am I worthy to do this? Am I capable enough to do this? Why do people entrust me to do things? I don't even trust myself to do these things, but would people trust things? I feel like I will mess up or, you know, do anything and stuff like that. But the thing is, it's when at those times, I cakap literally dengan diorang, cuba kau fikir Nabi Musa. Nabi Musa, Nabi Musa dia tu pelat. Dia tu dibesarkan oleh Firaun. Dan dia pernah accidentally, of course. Dia pernah terbunuh orang secara tak sengaja. Hi, hello. Syarifah Nadira. Syarifah Kak Nadira. Boleh? Thank you Kak Nadira. So sedih datang ke live ni. Where was I? Okay. So Nabi Musa has all of these things. So the thing is, bukan setakat Nabi Musa diampunkan dosa dia, bahkan dia diangkat jadi Nabi. So my point is, like, I will tell them, macam, you know, like, if dia yang ada seburuk-buruk sejarah pun, somehow Allah boleh angkat jadi Nabi, why are you belittling the trust that people put in you? Macam tu lah. Why do you macam, so macam tu lah, why do you belittle yourself? Why do you, like, not trust yourself? You know, like, Allah entrusted Musa with a very big responsibility despite his past. So why would you belittle yourself? Literally, seorang demi seorang kawan yang saya jumpa, saya ulang je cerita ni kat Nadia, dekat dia. Aku salam Kak Nadia. Hi, thank you for joining. Kalau ada apa-apa soalan boleh tanya. I'm just explaining of the what's the inspiration behind this book. Seorang demi seorang, saya memang ulang kisah Nabi Musa dekat dia. Tapi masa tu saya tahu itu je lah. You know, I like, you know, saya pun tahu story tu daripada translation Quran. Itu ibrah yang saya ambil daripada story tu lah. But I repeat it so much, you know, to my other friends. So when bila saya dapat peluang untuk terlibat dengan Butir Press, so this idea come back in me, and I think it fits like the healing tone from the Islamic perspective. So I thought, you know what? Why do I write about this? You know, I always membebel dengan my friends whenever I jumpa diorang, and I ulang cerita ni kat diorang whenever they are dealing with their own insecurities, when they don't trust themselves. So I was like, you know what, why don't I write about this? So I started researching. So actually there's quite a lot of researches that I did. I doubt this as much as I don't think this reference as much as Buku Glow by Auni Baharin, but it's still quite a lot lah. Definitely safe tak? InsyaAllah, but maybe tak upload kat sini kot, I upload kat YouTube. Macam tu. Apa tadi? So, when I say I research, so I want to make sure like I tell the details of the story properly. Like, sebab ni sirah. Sirah Islam. So we want to get the details right. So I tak adalah. So my strategy is I tak pergi YouTube macam just search random ustaz and then there's a small clip about Nabi Musa. No, I memang cari ustaz yang dia memang extensive. Like dia ada buat satu siri program untuk Nabi Musa. Basically it's being talk about deeply lah. So rather than just small clips daripada ustaz, saya cerita sama dia lain daripada story pasal Nabi Musa ke, so no, I don't count that as my research. So during that, I terjumpa Ustaz Majid Mahmud. So so if you nampak, takpelah, this is just the reference, jangan risau. But if you search oh wait, the name is not here, Ustaz Majid Mahmud. So turns out dia memang ada buat satu series program, a lecture series, kan, a lecture series pasal Nabi Musa. Ada 15, satu video, ada 15 video, satu video satu jam. I ended up katam semua video tu in like sehari, dua hari macam tu lah. Sebab dia macam like one day I jumpa and I was like, oh, this is good content. So esoknya I tengok lagi, but then I just got hooked, and hari ketiga I literally stayed up late, habiskan semua video dan playlist tu. So macam it was really nice. Initially I nak explore the beginning part lah of the story of Nabi Musa, essentially before he became a prophet. But just the story itself daripada Ustaz Majid Mahmud is so interesting, so I ended up just katam all of it lah. So that was very interesting, that was very insightful. So yeah, that's tu sedikit sebanyak lah on how I got inspired to write the book lah. Kerana dia ada soalan kena tanya. Sekejap eh. Excuse me. Sekejap eh. Mana tadi? Okay. Sorry, I'm on my laptop also looking at something. So, Kak Nadia dah pergi pesta buku ke hari ni? Like, cause I would like to know what the vibe is there kalau Kak Nadia dah pergi. And if possible, boleh tak recommend like tempat makan yang okay kat Sandi Putra? Because the thing is like, oh jauh ke? Okay, tak. Because the thing is, sebab biasa kat PWTC tu, kalau pesta buku, tempat makan di PWTC lah, obviously dekat tu ada Sandi Putra Mall. Tapi makanan-makanan kat PWTC tu is just like, it's not a heavy meal lah kan. It's just a snacking-snacking. So kalau I nak betul-betul macam makan berat dengan selesa ke apa, I need to go through the Sunway Putra Mall lah. But I didn't get to explore sangat. Nasib baiklah dulu, tahun lepas Pesta Buku Merdeka kan, dia buat kat dalam tu juga. So that's how I came about. But if you... saya sebut nama awak macam mana ya? Cyrus, boleh ke sebut Cyrus? Ya, saya Kelly. Saya Kelly Telly. I'm the author of You Are Deserving. Thank you for joining in tonight. Malam ni you are deserving. Ask me away. Semacam kalau ada soalan berkaitan dengan buku-buku ni, boleh tanya ke apa. Itulah, kena jalan kaki. Cyrus, don't mind us, we just talking about our experience kat Pesta Buku tahun lepas. Aduh, oh ya ke? Wah, that's... Oh, wow, thank you, kejap. Can I look it up? Kejap, I have my laptop tau ke depan ni. If you don't mind, can I look it up? Oh, subhanallah, thank you. Is it here on Instagram? Ke... Ah, dekat YouTube. Kejap, saya cari. Guna nama yang sama juga ke? Tak ada channel name. Cyrus, betul ke? Saya baca tu. Kejap, kerana dia chat apa. Itulah kan jalan kaki pergi Sunway Wall. Oh, pergi first time last year. I see. Untuk sekolah. Oh, subhanallah. Thank you very much. Cakap Nadia, last year ada stage event. Kalau tak, tak raja cakap sangat. Oh, your event ke Kak Nadia? Your event punya stage. I mean that was cool, tapi macam tu lah, kena jalan kaki kan. Nenek apa semua. So tu lah, I was looking for mana lah nak makan kat dekat Sunway Putra Mall ni. So macam, if anyone's watching yang boleh kasih recommendation, that could be nice also. While waiting for Cyrus, saya stop kat mana tadi? Kan nak stop apa? Macam mana? Dia cerita... Oh, dia cerita of researching pasal sirah Nabi Musa. Okay. The thing is, itu baru di bahagian Islam. Bahagian Islam lah. Sorry. Sebab personally, I divide this book into... Personally, to me, this book contains three elements. Okay. That's the better sentence. So pertama, pertama the Islamic aspect lah. Kan, that was very, ayat tu is very thought provoking lah. And to be honest, there's a lot more thought-provoking punya ayat. I letak tak nama manuscript I, but editor cakap, tolong delete, this is, you know, too strong for a healing book. And I was like, okay, tak apa, kita dengar cakap editor. Kejap ya. Ashifa Danisha. Oh, Danisha ya. Sering duti. Kejap ya, saya search. Terkejut, huh? You know, that's how you write a good intro, tau. Dia kasi hook sikit. Kejap ya, saya nak search ni. But then saya nak finishkan apa saya cakap tadi. Sering di TV. SMK Seri Dungun. Ah, I see. Oops. Okay. Apa tadi? Okay, so let me finish yang... So let me finish. This book ada tiga elemen. It's okay. I'll just like... No, I tengok nanti. Kejap ya. Oops, kejap eh. Okay. So this book... kejap, okay. And this book ada tiga elemen. Kenapa susah sangat nak habiskan? So elemen pertama is the Islamic part lah, the Sirah part pasal Nabi Musa. And macam saya dah cerita tadi, I do a lot of research about it. So secondly is the psychology punya part of the story. So saya graduan ijazah sarjana muda psikologi. So I try my best to put some psychological inputs, you know, talking about imposter syndrome, talking about sekejap apa lagi ya. Aduh, tengoklah Kak Nadia, saya kata saya study buku ni tak ingat lagi macam mana. Study 2-3 kali pun tak ingat lagi. Buku sendiri pula tu. pasal imposter syndrome, pasal self acceptance, pasal forgiveness. So there's some topics in that yang I try to kupas dari psikologi dah. Dan yang ketiga is my own personal story. So kepada yang dah baca, macam Danisha, itu 3 days to finish that books. Actually that's quite fast actually. Like sebab buku ni macam ada orang jenis yang baca tutup kejap dia kena hadam dulu macam ni. Hadam, dia buat kerja lain dulu and then baru datang balik. So biasanya orang lambat habiskan buku ni. So that is actually fast. So and thank you for reading it sampai habis. I really appreciate it. So as you finish reading it, so you know lah these 3 elements. So the last element is my own personal stories. Dalam tu where I talk about talk about my own journey melawan my social anxiety. It was really memorable. It was very personal for me to write that. Oh subhanallah, I cried writing it as well, obviously. But subhanallah. Kak Nadia belum habis. Tak apa kan, sebab hari tu like kita dah jumpa kan Kak Nadia. I know you tengah study juga, so macam like, so that was nice lah. Like tak apa, like you know, kita baca buku ni, it's not a race, you know, siapa baca cepat, siapa baca lambat ke apa. Like, you know, we all read our own pace. Kita kalau enjoy yang baca laju-laju, nice. Kalau kita suka enjoy baca perlahan-lahan pun nice. I design this book so that, you know, it can cater to both parties lah. Macam tu. So itulah 3 elemen tu. So 2 daripada elemen ni memang I need to do macam a lot of research lah. Kalau Danisha ada lagi dengan saya nak tanya Kak Nadia. Danisha dah baca. Kak Nadia dah baca, mana yang dah baca? Can you share with me macam apa yang memorable lah sebab saya baca tadi kan. Oh, relatable, menusuk dan sebagainya. So apa yang relatable tu? Apa yang menusuk juga? Sebab saya pun nak tahu juga. Ask me anything ni bukan kat saya pun. Saya pun boleh tanya juga, betul tak? tengah-tengah buku. Oh, subhanallah. Tengah-tengah buku yang mana je? Chapter 5. Chapter 5. Oh, second chances. Excuse me. Subhanallah, that was itulah I check, like, you know, when people ask me about the book, I always say, you know, what is your hope for the book? I always say, like, I hope it heals you reading. I hope it is healing to you reading it as much as it heals me writing it. So, and again, like, as I said, memang dekat chapter terakhir sekali, memang I said yang menggerakkan hati itu semua Allah. Saya cuma sekadar medium je. And I am happy that if Allah were to touch your hearts just by through the medium of me, you know, I'm just a medium. I just hope that this book would help you improve your relationship with Allah more and with yourself, with your own self more. Feeling of undeservingness. Hi, yes, Kak Nadia. Oh, yang paling menusuk bila ada quotes waktu akhir-akhir chapter. You mean like on each? Yes. Yes, they were very extracted, very beautifully. Sebab yang pilih yang hujung tu bukan saya actually. Like, it's the publisher lah. And like, I'm lucky that I get to work with Putih Press, with PTS. They're among the big publisher in Malaysia, so they know the market well. So they utilize that to help. So we together lah can help more souls yang membaca buku ni lah. So alhamdulillah. Ya, macam ni. I see. Itulah, actually Kak Nadia, like, that is among my favorite quotes juga in that book. Allah does not expect you to be perfect. Why do you expect yourself to be perfect? Kan? You know, kita kadang-kadang tak terfikir benda terima-terima macam tu. But me writing it myself knows, like, you know, Allah tak expect that from me. Why do I expect it from myself? Oh, tulis. So I said, like, alhamdulillah, so that realization to me, myself, when I was writing it was kind of cool. So macam, yeah. Part yang kena minta maaf to those around you, tak ada apa nak buat lagi. You know, take things slow. Like, Allah lebih tahu your situation. Saya bukannya, I'm not in a place to macam tell people to do anything. So it's okay to take your time. And as I mentioned also juga in this book, kita apa-apa pun kuatkan diri kita melalui relationship kita dengan Allah, relationship kita dengan diri sendiri. Try lah kuatkan diri kita dengan dua benda tu. Sebab memang dengan orang ni memang susah. So macam like Kak Nadia cakap tadi, like, memang kemaafan dengan manusia ni is a bit tricky. It doesn't mean that you shouldn't do it, but you can acknowledge that it's tricky and it's okay for you to macam, you know, maybe strategize ke, macam like, okay, you know, like, itulah to strategize and kumpul kekuatan, because it's a legit hard thing to do. So it's okay for you to take your time to kumpul kekuatan tu. So do it slowly, insyaAllah. Tak rasa kan, kita suka monolog dengan diri sendiri, ya. So banyak betul soalan mengenai. Fun fact, I am an only child. Saya anak tunggal. So memang literally daripada kecil, like, yeah, I literally cakap dengan diri sendiri. Like, I don't have anyone to play with as a kecil. So I dah biasa entertain my own self. Literally games yang biasa main dengan orang pun I main sendiri. Like congkak I boleh main sendiri, Monopoly I boleh main sendiri. Masa tanya macam mana Monopoly main seorang? And I was like, I don't know, I just play it. But yeah, like, so that's one fun fact about me. But yeah, also I'm a textbook introvert. Like, yang so macam like, yeah, I do tend to think a lot and overthink actually. So it's like so yeah, like I like to think a lot and craft a lot of ideas and theories in my head, which is much important lah. I mean, to anyone, like if you're interested in becoming a writer. Anak sulung saya macam tu, maybe soal aku dapat adik. Dia boleh baca alone. Oh my god. Wow, I can relate. The only reason I didn't play chess masa dulu adalah I didn't like it. But probably if I like it, I would play chess juga seorang-seorang dia, I guess. But you know, itulah, looking back, you know, children are amazing, you know. Like they have, they don't really adapt tau. They're very fast at adapting to things. So probably that's just what happened to me as well. But yeah, I see. Sekarang pun 9:30 ya. 9:30. So maybe around 15 minutes, I'll wrap it up. I'll wrap this up. Like sebab saya pun tak nak macam ambil masih lambat sangat ke apa. This is just a sesi santai-santai. Macam tu lah. Sorry kak, Kak Nadia duduk mana? Saya dah tanya ke hari tu masa kita kat Zoom tu, saya lupa pula. So Kak Nadia cakap jauh. Kak Nadia jauh daripada PWTC. Ah, Perak. I see. Okay, got it. Saya ada pergi tau pesta buku Perak tahun lepas. Dekat Aeon kan lah? Dekat Aeon. Dekat Aeon. Ah, macam tu lah. Tu first time lah saya pergi ke pesta buku luar Selangor just to see what it's like. And yeah, it was interesting and fun. How long did it take for me to write this book? Itulah, actually Alhamdulillah, a lot of the process, banyak Allah pemudahkan proses tulis buku ni sebab I work as a ghostwriter. So maksudnya like I tolong craftkan manuskrip buku untuk orang lain juga. So and I've actually been writing and researching pasal menulis buku ni for a long time already lah. And tolong orang dengan buku diorang, so that was a norm juga. I've been a writer for 7 years actually, and ghostwriter specifically macam maybe around 3 years macam tu. So Alhamdulillah I gain enough skills yang Alhamdulillah bila Putih Press datang dengan offer to write my book. This is my first book actually. So I sendiri expect macam oh this will be hard ah, like this is the first time I actually writing a book for myself. Tapi Alhamdulillah, like it took me 3 months actually to write this book. So yeah, 3 months. But the thing is, so jawapan sini sebenarnya ada dua lah. You can say this book took 3 months to write, but this book also took 7 years to write. So, but I've been a writer since 2017. So mungkin pada orang lain macam wah cepatnya tulis 3 bulan, macam boleh tulis cepat 3 bulan. But the thing is, I can write it in 3 months sebab all of the skills that I've honed for the past 7 years. So macam like, first and foremost Alhamdulillah for that. But yeah, itulah. Essentially it's a long-winded answer, but it took me 3 months lah to write this book. Nak tahu tak waktu pergi beli buku ramai-ramai cikgu, buku ni macam satu set tapi author lain-lain, tapi buku you yang dapat attention I first. Sebab the titles sangat interesting and the description sangat best. Oh my god, thank you so much. Kepada to people that are familiar with the process of publishing a book, actually tajuk dia senang berubah tau, macam akan tajuk ni tu. Like even contoh the blurb kat belakang ni, people would write a few draft and so macam banyak benda yang berubah lah. But for this particular title, memang I dah terfikir even sebelum sebelum. So basically what happened with this book is macam I kena hantar proposal dululah. So memang tajuk ni dah ada sejak dalam proposal tu. And I pun dah jatuh sayang dengan tajuk tu. I was like, what? Tajuk apa lagi sesuai kalau kita nak cerita pasal this whole thing selain you are deserving. You are deserving. I really can't think of another title, like that's it. That's the title, you know. So even lepas habis, dah habis tulis buku ni, macam like contoh illustration semua dah siap, layout buku semua dah siap kan. That's why I come to the title. Okay, tajuk macam mana? And I was like, please stick with the tajuk, please. I really like this tajuk, please. So macam lah, I was like, okay, like, let's stick to the tajuk. So alhamdulillah lah, I'm glad that I fight for that tajuk. So macam like, alhamdulillah, thank you. And again, ni semua aturan Allah lah. Allah yang menggerakkan hati untuk beli dan buka, beli dan baca. Tolong buka pinggir menulis. Adik. Like, you know, there are a few plans ahead. Macam Kak Nadia pun dah datang. Apa kita buat hari tu? Anish lah. Pasal Anish kan? Itulah, saya so far macam berani buat webinar pun cuma pendek-pendek je. Sebab saya rasa tak adalah saya ni. Ada ramai je lagi penulis yang lagi pandai, lagi berbakat daripada saya, yang lagi layak buat kelas kot. Saya rasa saya ni siapa je nak buat kelas kan? But again, on the other side, you know, like, you know, I'm not buka kelas nak on the expectation of nak melahirkan SPS, but also, you know, if we think about it, macam, you know, I just, you know, I've been writing for 7 years. Apa yang saya boleh sharing sikit-sikit, itulah yang saya share. So that's what I aim lah. The title you are deserving memang direct. Better tajuk direct daripada tajuk belit-belit. I mean, thank you, Nurit. Thank you, Kanadia. I tengah perah otak and figuring out the, bukanlah logistics tapi, you know, just figuring out the details lah. Macam, you know, kalau betul I nak bagi kelas, kelas apa I nak offer, dan especially betul ke in my line of expertise, like bukannya setakat kelas nak kumpul fans, kumpul ke apa. Macam I mean, actually that is true juga. I had to fikir pasal macam mana, again, this macam saya cakap, penulis yang lebih expert daripada saya kan, like sebab dia orang lebih expert lah daripada saya, they are more, tak, dia lebih sibuk dengan hal-hal yang lain, hal-hal yang lebih penting actually. So sometimes people daripada step zero, dia bukan nak terus pergi ke finish line pun, kadang-kadang dia nak pergi ke step one je kan. Step one, step two, step three. So kadang-kadang orang-orang, maybe lah orang-orang macam saya lah yang tak berapa sibuk ni, yang boleh tolong tunjukkan step lain seterusnya, step yang seterusnya. Mungkin lah kan, macam tu lah. Thank you, Danisha. Like, kejap. Excuse me. So, tadi apa serindu TV eh? Ya, nanti I'll check your like review. Look forward for it. Thank you very much. Permudahkanlah. Itulah. Now that you mention it, Danisha, like, if I were to write another book, what do you think macam topik yang sesuai? Ini teringin nak survey kan? Survey market. Cik, tak adalah. Tarik tanganku, patah hati dengan previous experience. Kenapa patah hati kah? Apa jadi? Aduh. But tadi, anyway, like, to Danisha, if you can, like, macam recommend macam next topics ke apa, sebab, again, this is my first book. So macam, dan Alhamdulillah, buku ni actually masa pesta buku, masa pesta buku alternatif Kuala Lumpur yang dekat Pasar Seni tu, sebab buku ni memang terbit bulan 2, lepas tu terus pesta buku alternatif. Buku ni turn up to be, kalau PTS, dalam semua buku PTS, dia masuk top 3, terlaris. Dan buku Putih Press masa tu, ni yang paling terjual. So, masa tu I was macam very shocked, and I was like, you know, this is my first book, orang tak kenal saya pun, macam like, wow. Tapi masa tu I work under the assumption that, oh, sebab ni buku terbaru Putih Press, Comfort Series, so orang nak macam dapatkan lah kan. Maksudnya it's not really about me or my writing, it's about the publisher and about the series. So actually pesta buku kali ni, baru saya boleh dapatkan betul-betul feedback. Macam contoh dengan Danisha kan, Danisha actually read the whole book and can tell me, you know, what you like about this book, and even maybe what you macam tak berapa ni sangat lah pasal buku ni. So this is actually the time for me to hear the feedback. So from that feedback, I would, itulah, kita tengok lah macam mana nanti. Danisha pun tak tahu. Okay, tak apa, no worries. Ajak, tadi Seridu TV tu SMK Sri Dungun, ya? Maksudnya Danisha dekat kedah lah ni, ya? Sekejap, apa tadi kat Nadia? Oh, nak suruh panjang. Itulah, bila masalah kat Nadia? Bila nak jumpa tu? Tak apalah, insyaAllah ada rezeki kan, kita boleh jumpa face to face. Perak tu, I don't know, kadang-kadang 3 bulan sekali rentas lah sikit, kadang-kadang singgah. Tapi saya biasa singgah Ipoh lah. Terengganu. Dungun Terengganu ya. Minta maaf. Okay, see. Hopefully. Sebab my writing. Oh, subhanallah. Subhanallah, thank you so much. Thank you for the feedback, macam obviously itulah macam saya cakap, this is the time where I actually boleh dengar apa yang people like about the book. So macam like, thank you. Tadi saya tak habis cakap tadi sebenarnya. Oh, okay. So from hearing that feedback, so what I plan is, about the new start of the book. A book about a new start. Oh, I see. That's interesting. Yeah, that will be macam interesting topic to cover sebab, itulah, I nak habiskan ayat tadi. Sebab daripada feedback ni, macam baru I boleh draft macam if I want to write another book, what topic would I write? The thing is, macam I like the formula already. Macam kita ambil satu sirah Nabi, Nabi Muhammad boleh, Nabi-Nabi yang lain pun boleh. Like, apa masalah yang orang muda kita ada sekarang ni yang kita boleh ambil ibrah daripada kisah Nabi tu? What are the psychological macam theories or concepts or macam studies yang sokong benda ni? And kalau boleh, if I have personal stories yang relatable lah dengan dua-dua ni. So I think that is a good formula for me to write like quote-unquote buku healing next time. Sebab banyak buku healing, macam banyak puisi kan, apa semua kan. Which is of course, like, itu pun jenis buku pun, it's a beauty in of itself. Tapi macam kalau saya memang selesa tulis buku yang macam ni lah. Like, it's a typical book yang you would macam expect. And it's more focus on research on secondary, at least secondary material lah kan. Sekejap ya. Jangan plan lama sangat. Maybe your first student. InsyaAllah kita tengok eh. Kita tengok yang macam mana. Aduh. Okay. Ini. Sekejap. Okay, I think sekejap sekarang 9.42. Okay lah, I think I wrap this up. I wrap this up with two things. Actually, just nak bagi tahu lah. So for this upcoming Pesta Buku Antarabangsa ni, like I officially will be there for 2 days. So hari pertama adalah Isnin, 27 Mei, dekat pentas utama. Kita akan ada discussion, maybe in form of forum lah I guess. Sebab so it's a discussion slash forum pasal the comfort series of Putih Press. So kita ada Umar Ahmad Dain dengan kita ada Kak Sharifah Nadira. And then the third panelist is me. So we'll talk about the comfort series. So tu hari Isnin 27 Mei pukul 11 pagi di pentas utama. So tu hari yang pertama. Hari yang kedua adalah hari Rabu. Hari Rabu 29 Mei dekat booth PTS, Pavilion PTS. Yang tu meet and greet, the standard meet and greet lah. So tu pukul 1, saya pukul 2. So macam like you can boleh saya, so I dah upload pun apa dia punya details dekat my IG. So memandangkan Nadia seorang kat Perak dan Nisha, kat Nadia kat Perak dan Nisha dekat Terengganu, so tak apa, boleh juga inform dekat kawan-kawan lain yang maybe nak turun BBKL ke. So I will be there for those 2 days, 27 Mei, sorry, hari Isnin dengan hari Rabu. Macam lah, tu, ya yeah, tu ya, yeah. So that's the 2 days lah, I will be there. I mean maybe, moga Allah juga pemudahkan urusan Kak Nadia dan urusan dan Syah. So yeah, like Alhamdulillah kepada yang join malam ni, thank you very much for joining. If you like this book, Alhamdulillah, thank you so much. Boleh bagi rating ke mana-mana platform that you selalu frequent. Maybe it's Shopee, maybe it's Goodreads or something. Yeah, maybe Goodreads, and boleh terus recommend lah dekat buku-buku, dekat kawan-kawan yang lain. Macam, I actually recommend this to be as a gift out to friends. Sebab memang a lot of writers yang I baca, sorry, there's a lot of readers yang I jumpa, dia memang terus macam ambil lagi satu kopi sebab oh nak hadiahkan dekat someone else. And I was like, oh yeah, I was very moved by that when they do that. So yeah, if this book benefit you, like I encourage you to macam to recommend it to others and to you, to others lah. I can't remember I'll highlight anything dalam buku tu. So, oh sebab buku property kena di perpustakaan. Oh sudah di perpustakaan. Itulah, insyaAllah harapnya nanti Terengganu kan, I think ada tu Pesta Buku Terengganu, nanti ada, hopefully Danisha will be there and finally will be able to purchase the book lah. So boleh tulis syok. So macam Alhamdulillah, insyaAllah lah. But yeah, anyway, like thank you lah, like sorry, I'm a bit nak melalu pula. Maybe it's night dan kita dah mengantuk-antuk sikit. That's so much. So yeah, if there's nothing else, I would like to end the live here again. Thank you very much. Kak Nadia, Indonesia sedi stay until the end. I hope you punya urusan juga dipermudahkan. And insyaAllah kalau ada rezeki, kalau tak PBAKL ni di masa-masa akan datang nanti, like kita direzekikan untuk berjumpa. InsyaAllah, amin. Tak dulu. Okay, bye. Assalamualaikum. Saya tutup ya. Bye.